Hello everyone, my name is Chandrakant Singh Tegam and I am the faculty for this subject Biomedical Instrumentation and Analytical Method. So first of all we start with the basics of Biomedical Instrumentation and Analytical Methods. There is a portion in your first unit which states the fundamentals of biopotential. Why? Instead you are well understood the concepts of fundamental of biopotential like action potential and effect on muscles. If you do not understand the action potential and effect of muscles, you cannot design a device for measurement of ECG, measurement of EMG, measurement of EEG, right? So first you need to know the just basic biology behind this. Some of the students have taken their biology in their 12th or 11th, right? And some not. So there is no need to worry about it. There is a simple biological explanation and we'll relate this biological explanation with our electronics counterpart, right? So no need to worry. First of all, this is the basic building blocks we most of all familiar, the cell. The basic property of the cell is that, or you can say that cell membrane, the wall here is that it just does not allow the movement of ions inside of the cell and toward outside of the cell. Why? Because in our human body there are so many ions in aqueous medium. In that aqueous medium our cell is also the part of that aqueous medium, right? And that aqueous medium called as ECF. Whatever the liquid medium outside of the cell is called as ECF, and whatever medium inside of that particular cell is called ICF. So there is a potential difference between ICF and ECF. There is an accumulation of positive charge outside and there is an accumulation of negative charge inside. So the most important point, in your ECF there is a ion Na plus which is found in abundance, right? And in your ICF there is also Na plus. Apart from this K plus, Cl minus and many more, they also are simply existing all over this system. But the concept of this action potential based on the travel of these ions means Na plus inside to the cell and toward inside and toward outside. So what happens? There is an abundance of Na plus in the ECF and there is a less amount of Na plus in ICF. So it creates a relative potential difference. Understand this, there is a relative potential difference. Means Na plus bahut zyada hai bahar, isliye wahan pe positive zyada hai. ICF mein Na plus less quantity mein, positive yahan bhi hai, but agar ICF se compare kare ECF ko, so ECF mein zyada positive ions hai Na plus and ICF mein Na plus kam hai. So due to this difference of ions, there is a concept called resting potential. Resting potential mein at rest the minus 90 millivolt will be the potential difference which exists all over the membrane surface. There is a potential difference, mind you, minus 90 millivolt. Understood this? Now, how we are going to generate this action potential is lies on a factor which called as stimulus, means externally हम कोई externally एक stimulus देंगे और उस stimulus से ये जो potential difference का system है इसे disturb करेंगे और फिर देखते हैं इस stimulus का effect क्या होता है. But this stimulus has to cross two basic criteria. The value must be plus 30 millivolt, must be plus 30 millivolt, and the duration is must be greater than 1 millisecond. Why? We'll see in graph of action potential, generation of action potential. So stay with me and stay vigilant. Minus 90 millivolt, minus 60, 0 millivolt, plus 20 millivolt. This process is called your process A, this is B, and this one is C. I'll explain one by one. See here. What I have explained later is that the cell membrane has this potential difference which called as resting potential, which is the which has the value minus 90 millivolt. We are going to disturb this system via stimulus here, and this will give this point action potential. Now how it happens? See, at the resting state the cell membrane potential value is here, resting, minus 90 millivolt. When the stimulus is applied, mind you, the stimulus is applied and it checks all the boxes that it must be greater than or equal to 1 millisecond, right? And it must be plus 30 millivolt value, right? These two boxes are checked, then only this process will perform. Otherwise, this will not gonna happen, right? When stimulus of appropriate duration and appropriate value is applied at the cell membrane, the resting potential value changes from minus 90 millivolt to minus 60 millivolts. How? The stimulus value, this plus 30 millivolts, gets add up in this. So minus 90 plus 30 equal to minus 60. What is the unit? Millivolt. Minus 60 millivolt. Now see here, all these structure of cell membrane, there are little gates, or you can say that channels, which open only the stimulus of particular duration and particular value is gonna be applied. After the stimulus, appropriate stimulus application, when the potential reaches this point, minus 60 millivolt, then these gates are open. Now what's gonna happen? This Na plus, abundance of Na plus, move rapidly inside the cell, or Na plus from ECF will rapidly move toward the ICF through this gated channel, and the effect can be shown here. Minus 60, minus 50, minus 40, then 0 millivolt, then till plus 20 millivolts. This is the peak, or you can say that excited state. After that, there is no rapid inflow of Na plus inside ICF, right? Now what happens here? The influence of stimulus is fade off till this point, right? But the effect of stimulus यहाँ आपका शुरू हुआ था, इस point of time पे, इस duration तक था, उसका effect थोड़ी देर तक रहा, इस point के बाद तो कोई stimulus नहीं है. Now the basic tendency of the cell is that it will try to regain its natural state, or this minus 90 millivolt. Now what happens? This ICF will flush out the Na plus outside of the cell boundaries, which will result in this process called repolarization. And this one is the earlier process, is called as depolarization. Depolarization, we are disturbing the natural state or resting state of the cell via applying stimulus of particular duration and particular value. Depolarization, this is the excited state. Now the natural tendency of cell is being dominated. Now it is again try to attain the resting potential or natural state. So this process, the repolarization, rapid outflow of Na plus, which shows up here again, plus 20 millivolt, plus 10, then 0, minus 10, minus 20, till minus 90. But this rapid outflow of Na plus is getting somewhat carried away after this point. So what happens when cell rechecks its resting potential? It has found that it has crossed this point. Now minus 10 millivolt is not the resting potential. Then what happens? Then it again try to regain its position without any stimulus. Mind you, cell is trying to regain its natural position from this excited state all by itself without any stimulus. So the rapid outflow, then a brief moment of inflow, then outflow, then inflow, outflow, and after a brief moment of time, it will regain the minus 90 millivolt mark. right? And this slow inflow and outflow, this period is called as refractory period, right? So this is the basic of action potential, how we are going to generate action potential. And now coming to our next topic, the effect on muscles. There can be a lengthy explanation of one paragraph or two paragraph, how this is gonna happen, how this biological entity will take over, how this biological process take place, but just a simple explanation and you are done. So effect on muscles. As we have seen in case of cell, this is the polarized state or resting state. There is a phenomenon of polarization happen, plus 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 outside, minus 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 inside. There is the occurrence of a stimulus, so disturbance of ions inside the cell and disturbance of ion outside the cell. This phenomena takes over here, the effect of a stimulus going on and on till this state, again completely mirror image, inside plus 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 plus, outside minus minus minus. After this state, the natural state is gonna regain by the muscles, and this plus 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 minus minus and this. Whenever you apply the action potential on muscles, this will be the standard response. There can be a biological explanation also, and there can be a diagrammatic representation also. So in my opinion, this diagrammatic explanation is way simpler and much easy to understand, right? So for today, just revise this concept, right? The generation of action potential, the concept of cell membrane, the Na plus ICF and ECF, resting membrane, and this effect on muscle. So for now, it's enough for first lecture. Revise it and okay. Stay home, stay safe.